kingdom purpose, kingdom dominion, discipling nations. Whether you realize it or not, you were created to establish God's kingdom on earth. Hello, and welcome to the Kingdom Network. I am Abraham John. It's time to rediscover God's kingdom. Does it seem like some teachings today are trying to change your purpose on earth? What about our disobedience to God? Does that change our purpose? Is man's dominion still functioning as God intended? Everything is functioning as God planned from the very beginning, at least in its present fallen state, except the born-again believers. That sounds ridiculous, doesn't it? The birds are still flying and the dogs are still barking. Ever since the fall, religiously deceived people have been trying to change our purpose and escape this planet. God never told man he was changing his mind concerning our purpose, dominion, because sin has entered in. He never did. We live in confusing times, even within the church. To help you through these times, we have launched a four-part series on dominion. Last week, we started our journey in rediscovering our purpose. It is the most exciting journey you will ever take. At the end, you will be able to say without the shadow of doubt the reason of your existence, the purpose of your life in one sentence. Let's get started. Take notes and re-watch these shows multiple times. They will be available at the kingdomnetwork.org website. Tell your friends about your journey and these teachings. Together, we can advance His kingdom. So, what is our purpose? Why were we created? The answer is found in the book of Genesis. In chapter 1, verse 26 states the simple truth. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, over the cattle, over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth." As I said before, that is our purpose statement. Don't forget that. God created us to have dominion over the earth. The word dominion is very complex. Kings have kingdoms, and kingdoms have dominion. That word shows that we were created as kings. It is written in Revelation chapter 1, verse 6. It says, "And He has made us kings and priests to His God and Father. To Him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen." I love that verse. The word dominion comes from the ancient Hebrew word rada. The Holy Spirit has given me 12 definitions of the word dominion. Many people misunderstand its meaning. People have come up with all sorts of theologies in the last days, like the dominion now, dominion later, or dominion never or somewhere theology. This and others are very prevalent in many Christian circles. The good news is that God never changed His mind concerning man's purpose just because Adam fell. Even with our disobedience, we are still created in His image and likeness, and that will never change. Neither does our purpose. Nowhere in the Bible does it say that God changed His mind concerning our purpose. Whatever God spoke over His creation is still going on today. The word dominion means to rule. That is the number one definition we discussed on the last show. Then the second one is to govern. So then it is to manage, to master, to establish, to be fruitful, to restore, to work, to subdue, to overcome, to maximize, and cultivate. Each one of our callings is connected to one of those definitions. Last week, we talked about on how to rule and to govern. It is our natural instinct to rule. Just like it's natural instinct for a fish to swim or a bird to fly. They don't go to school to learn to do that. Have you seen a bird going to school to learn how to fly? No, we don't see that because a natural instinct. And it is the natural instinct God put in mankind to rule this planet. And mankind have been doing it ever since God put us on the earth, except us. That's my challenge. So God never intended for any unrighteous person to be in the place of authority in any country. That's what we read in Proverbs 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, people rejoice. When the wicked rules, people groan. So then we learned that the second definition of dominion is to govern. A ruler needs governors like leaders, and visionaries need managers. Let's take a look at the next three definitions of dominion: to manage, to master, and to establish. So today's show, the first one is to manage. What does that mean? As God's children, we need to be managers of this planet. We need to manage the resources, the nature, and everything else He has entrusted us to us. We will need a lot more people to manage this planet. Some people think that there are too many people on the earth already, but in reality, we do not have enough. There is plenty of place on this earth that needs to be occupied. The only reason that we think there are too many people is because of our congested cities. I was just in New Delhi, one of the largest cities in India, almost 20 million people. You know, we talk about traffic jam here. In India, we talk about people jam. You hit shoulder to shoulder when you walk down the street, but there are plenty more land to be occupied for God's kingdom on this planet Earth. In truth, more cities needs to be established. When I travel across nations, I found that almost every one of them has the ruins of some old cities and civilizations that existed within them hundreds or even thousands of years ago. Now only their ruins remain. Those cities and towns disappeared, and people moved on and built new cities. Why can't we do the same today? It is absolutely possible. I believe it. It needs to happen. Newer and better cities are yet to be built. All major cities in this blessed country of United States are not even 200 years old. People came here and built these wonderful cities. So we can do the same, and we can do it again. So the next definition of the word dominion is to master. Don't forget that, okay? I want you to grab this in your heart. Each of us needs to master an area of life. I'm going to give you a key to your prosperity. To master means to become the best in something. We all try different things, then nothing works out for us because we don't master anything. When you master something, you're qualified to teach it to others. A skill, a talent, a gift, a language, a subject, or even a trick. Anything spiritual or natural can be mastered. When you master something, people will come to you and pay you for your service. Did you hear that? That is the key to prosperity. When you master something and do it like nobody else did before, you will have dominion and you will never be poor again in your life. Discover the gift or the gifts God gave you. He has given us at least one gift, every human being. Nobody born to this planet Earth or came to this planet Earth without a gift. The reason maybe you don't know what is the gift God has given you, because you have not discovered that yet. But the Bible says at least one, every one of us received, maybe five, two, one, and many, but we have to master them. Just because a gift is there, that doesn't mean it will automatically manifest. It may remain dormant until we tap into it, master it, and use it to bless other people. So why did I say master a trick? There are people who have mastered juggling. Have you seen that on television? And I love to see people juggling something. I have seen them do it before huge audience. As the Bible says, your gift will make room for you and bring you before great men. Proverbs 18, 16. That's one of my another favorite words. Your gift will bring you before great men. Mastered gift will bring you income and bring you before great people. Whatever we do, we need to excel in that area and go to the next level. If you're working for a company, gain every bit of knowledge and skill required for you to excel in your workplace so you can move up to the next level. Never stay in one level for more than 3 years. Amen. The potential God put inside of us is unfathomable. Most of us don't realize it unless we are stretched, trained, and required to grow. Unless we demand it, it will not manifest on its own. It will remain dormant. Right now, we have no idea how many skills remain sleeping in our hands, in these fingers. With our two hands, we can fly an airplane, play an instrument, write a book, cook a meal, drive a car, or bless somebody, or build a skyscraper. It is impossible for me to list everything our hands can do. And also, if you teach our hands bad habits like smoking or drinking, it will eventually kill you. So may the Lord help us to discover the gifts that He has given to us by birth. We have natural gifts, spiritual gifts, and ministry gifts, and also the gifts that you learn by education when you go to school. So when you discover those gifts and master it and use it for your life on the earth, you will never be poor on the earth. So may the Lord help you to discover that. We have some wonderful resources for you to discover on our website. All you have to do is to go to thekingdomnetwork.org, and you can find these resources on how to discover your calling, your gift, and your anointing that God has given you. You can download this wonderful book called Rediscovering Your Lost Kingdom, and this will bless you. And please share it with other people and your friends, because these teachings will bless you. So thank you so much for watching. I'm going to pray for you right now so God will open the eyes of our understanding, and He will give you the revelation on what area of life that you need to master, the gift or the calling. Father, I thank you for your grace and your anointing right now. Those who are watching, I call those gifts to manifestation. You may be wondering, what is the gift that is in you? I pray that the Holy Spirit will reveal that to you in Jesus Christ's holy name. Thank you so much for watching today. Living in God's kingdom is not for the future, but it is for today. That's where we find our identity, purpose, and passion. Again, I invite you to visit our website, thekingdomnetwork.org, and ask you to join with a monthly giving to help us help others discover their purpose and disciple nations, and to preach the gospel of the kingdom on every nation on earth before Jesus comes back. So make sure you tune in next week, so we'll continue the 12 definitions of the word dominion, because this is very foundational and this is very fundamental, and that you catch hold of this revelation in your spirit man, because this is very key to discovering your purpose. So thank you, and I will see you next week. Tell your friends about it, and until next time, I'm Abraham Jones.